Hello viewers, welcome to my channel, Human Diseases and Genes. Today I will discuss about spinal muscular atrophy, that is SMA. A spinal muscular atrophy was first described in 1891 by German neurologist Ludo Werdnig and later in 1893 by Johann Hoffmann. In 1891, Werdnig published his observation of two brothers with muscle weakness, reduced muscle tone and muscle weakness. He described the clinical features of what is now known as the severe form of SMA, characterized by early onset and very rapid progression. In 1893, Hoffmann expanded on Werdnig's observation by describing additional cases of children with similar symptoms. His detailed clinical description and reports of family history helped establish the hereditary nature of the disease. Due to their contribution, the severe form of SMA is sometimes referred to as Werdnig-Hoffmann disease. SMA is a genetic disorder characterized by the progressive degeneration of motor neurons in the spinal cord and brainstem. These motor neurons are responsible for controlling voluntary muscle movements such as crawling, walking, swallowing, and breathing. The loss of these neurons leads to muscle weakness and atrophy over time. Different types of SMA have been observed. The first one is type 1, which is also known as Werdnig-Hoffmann disease. It is the most common and severe form of SMA, accounting for about 50 to 60% of all cases. Type 2 SMA represents approximately 20 to 30% of SMA cases. Type 3, which is also known as Kugelberg-Welander disease, accounts for about 10 to 20% of cases. And type 4 is adult onset form of SMA. It's rare and represents a small percentage of overall cases. The severity and onset of symptoms can vary depending on the type of SMA. But common symptoms include muscle weakness, hypotonia, scoliosis, joint contractures, cardiac issues, difficulty in breathing, and difficulty in swallowing. Muscle weakness is the hallmark of SMA, affecting the voluntary muscles used for activities like walking, swallowing, and breathing. And weakness may begin in the legs, arms, or torso. Muscle weakness often progresses over time as motor neurons are lost, muscles shrink, and become thinner. Often most pronounced in the limbs, especially in the lower body. Fine tremors in the hands and fingers may occur, especially in infants. Difficulty with movements such as crawling, standing, walking, or sitting. SMA is primarily caused by mutations in the survival motor neuron 1, that is SMN1 gene, but other genes can also be involved in the condition, contributing to different types and severity of SMA. SMN1 gene is located on the long arm of chromosome 5 at the position 1312 and consists of 9. The gene size is 20 kb, encoding a protein of 294 aminos. SMA affects approximately 1 in 10,000 live births globally. The exact prevalence can vary slightly depending on the population and region. It is estimated that about 1 in 50 people are carriers of a mutation in the SMN1 gene. Carriers do not show symptoms of SMA, but can pass a mutated gene to their offspring. Type 1 SMA is the most common and severe form of SMA. SMA is being identified more frequently and at an earlier stage. This early detection allows for prompt intervention which can significantly improve outcomes for affected individuals and provide more accurate data on the prevalence of the disorder. Diagnosis of SMA typically involves a combination of clinical assessment, genetic testing, and sometimes additional tests. A doctor will review the patient's medical history and symptoms. Common symptoms include muscle weakness, reduced muscle tone, difficulty in movement, and respiratory problems. Symptoms can range from mild to severe, and the age of onset is one important factor in determining the type of SMA. Neurological examination includes checking muscle strength, reflexes, tone, and coordination. In SMA, the muscle strength usually decreases progressively and reflexes may be diminished or absent. Electromyogram, that is EMG, tests the electrical activity of muscles and can help assess the health of motor neurons. In SMA, the electrical signals may be abnormal due to the loss of motor neurons. The most definitive way to diagnose SMA is through genetic testing to identify mutations in the SMA1 gene, which is responsible for the production of the survival motor neuron protein. Mutation or deletion in this gene leads to the loss of motor neurons in the spinal cord. The number of copies of the SMA2 gene can also be analyzed, as this gene produces a backup SMN protein that can partially compensate for the lack of SMN1 protein. The number of SMN proteins, SMN2 copies, is linked to the severity of SMA. The therapy for SMA has seen significant advances in recent years, particularly with the development of gene therapies and disease-modifying treatments that aim to address the underlying genetic cause of the condition. The treatment approach varies depending on the type of SMA, the age of the patient, and the severity of symptoms. SMN-enhancing therapies aim to increase the production of SMN protein from the SMN2 gene, which particularly compensates for the loss of SMN1 function. Spinraza is an antisense oligonucleotide that modifies the splicing of the SMN2 gene, leading to increased production of functional SMN protein. It is delivered via intrathecal injection directly into the spinal fluid and requires multiple doses. An initial loading series, 4 doses over 2 months, followed by maintenance doses every 4 months. Spinraza has been shown to improve motor function, respiratory function, and survival in children with SMA, particularly in those diagnosed early. Evrysdi is approved for the treatment of SMA in patients up to 2 months of age and older. It is an oral medication that also enhances the production of SMN protein from the SMN2 gene, similar to Spinraza, but it works in a slightly different manner. Evrysdi is taken as a daily oral dose. This is a more convenient option compared to Spinraza, as it does not require injection. Clinical trials have shown that Evrysdi improves motor function and survival rates in patients, particularly when initiated early. Gene therapy aims to address the root cause of SMA by introducing a functional copy of the SMN1 gene or enhancing the production of SMN1 protein. FDA approved Zolgensma for gene therapy of SMA. Zolgensma is a gene therapy that is approved for the treatment of SMA in children under 2 years of age, including infants with the most severe form, that is type 1 SMA. It delivers a functional copy of the SMN1 gene to the motor neuron, helping to introduce the SMN protein. This helps prevent further motor neuron degeneration and improve motor function. Plasma is administered as a one-time intravenous infusion. It is considered most effective when it is given early in the course of the disease, especially before symptoms begin severe. If administered early within the few months of the life, it can significantly improve survival, motor function, and independence in infants with SMN. Early diagnosis and intervention are crucial for improving outcomes in SMN. Treatments with chalazmide, brainstem, FSGR offer substantial improvement in survival, motor function, and quality of life, particularly when initiated early. This is all about spinal muscular atrophy. Thanks for watching. If you found this video helpful and learned something new, please like this video and don't forget to subscribe. Share this video with your friends and family to spread awareness. If you have any questions or queries, drop into comment box. Don't miss my next video. Until then, stay informed and take care of your health. Thank you. Thank you very much.